Surrey TV, I'm Victoria Durant, and this week we're at the David Shepherd Wildlife Foundation Gallery in Shalford. Let's go and take a look. Two brothers from Reigate have been nominated for 4 Brit Awards in this year's Music Awards ceremony as the electronic music duo Disclosure. The two Reigate College students, Guy and Howard Lawrence, who only released their first electro dance album in June last year, have been nominated in Best British Breakthrough Act, Best British Group, Best British Single, and MasterCard British Album of the Year categories. The ceremony will take place at the O2 on the 19th of February and will be screened live at 8 p.m. on ITV. Surrey County Council has set aside millions of pounds to repair the county's flood-damaged roads, bridges, footpaths and drains after the dramatic recent weather conditions. The repair programme will be launched after the Army of Council Inspectors have assessed and prioritised the work that needs to be done. The priority will be to get the roads cleared in order to return to pre-flooding movement again. Surrey County Council leader David Hodge said, "We'll spend the money we need so that we can repair Surrey's roads affected by the recent severe weather. We're continuing to do all we can along with the District Council and Borough Councils to help Surrey communities." Residents and drivers are being urged to use caution when they're out and about and to check in on any vulnerable neighbours they think may need help. I'm now really excited to be joined by Sally Case, CEO of the Foundation. So Sally, it's 30 years this year, isn't it, of the Foundation. You've got lots of stuff coming up, haven't you, with that?
We have. We're very excited to be celebrating our 30th anniversary. For this area, we're really excited. We have an event on Thursday the 27th of March at Surrey University. And it's telling the tale of Sunny, the orphan elephant, who was shown on TV earlier this week. Paul O'Grady visited her in her home in Zambia. She was attacked by poachers with an axe and suffered the most horrific wounds, resulting in paralysis on her leg. And so the world has been galvanised to support her. People have flown in from Scandinavia, from America, to give her leg braces and acupuncture. And her treatment has just been incredible. And her improvement has been amazing. And her story is being told at the university. So please buy tickets. Please come and hear all about us and support her work. It's davidshepherd.org for tickets.
Wow, it sounds really inspirational. And how else can we help to raise money for your charity?
Oh, every penny helps. I can hand on heart tell you every penny goes to support these vital projects. We have a raffle on at the moment for just £1, £1 a ticket. You could possibly win a David Shepherd original, which obviously values at thousands and thousands of pounds. And so it's a fantastic opportunity to win this beautiful painting here as well. So, and there are also wonderful prizes, including dinner and staying at the Dorchester in London and an Emily Lamb as well. So really, really important prizes and important work for wildlife.
Well, well done, you're doing such wonderful work. Thank you, Sally. Staying with council news for a moment, local firms have benefited to the tune of almost £1 million a day as part of a Surrey County Council pledge to back business. Annual figures reveal that 4,300 local companies secured £363 million worth of contracts from the council, the equivalent of just under £1 million a day. That means that local spending on goods and services has surged to 52% as the council pushes towards its target of 60%. Compare this with 3 years ago when the council spent only roughly a third of its money locally. Surrey County Council leader David Hodge said, "Local businesses are the bedrock of every community, and if they thrive, we all thrive. Our job is to help them do what they do best, create jobs, promote growth, and ensure their communities prosper. That is why we've pledged to ensure 60% of our spending is with local firms." The comedy club is set to launch next month at the Star Inn in central Guildford. Kickback Comedy will host comedy nights in the back room, a venue that is a building with a solid reputation for quality nights of entertainment. The debut for the new club will be on the 1st of February at 8 p.m. and will feature Johnny Katz, Chastity Butterworth and Nick Revel. All of the acts are regulars of the London circuit and have established themselves, as well as the MC for the evening, Deborah Jane Appleby. Abigail Bagley, a director of Kickback Comedy, told Surrey TV, "I'm looking forward to running a back to basics comedy club in Guildford. The Star Inn's back room will give the audience that intimate magic atmosphere that comedians love to perform to." Tickets are available from kickbackcomedy.com or from the Tourist Information Centre in the High Street, Guildford. This will be a popular night, so it's advised to get your tickets as soon as possible to secure your seats. The Sleep Out, Sleep Easy is fast approaching. Chantelle went to meet up with Diana Roberts at the Watts Gallery this week.
Surrey TV are here today at the Watts Gallery and I'm joined by our very good friend Diana Roberts. So Diana, we're here today to talk about the Sleep Easy Sleep Out because it's a charity event that you're going to be actually doing here at the Watts Gallery.
It's going to be here, yes, on the 1st of February. Me and a crowd of a few others, I think there's about 10 or 12 of us in all, we're going to be sleeping rough here all night from 8 o'clock at night to 8 o'clock in the morning.
And it's in a month's time, as you say, it's on the 1st of February and it's absolutely freezing at the moment, even standing here.
I know,
right now.
I'm a bit worried that it might snow because it turns into Narnia around here. I mean, it's very beautiful. We're not going to see much of it on the night, to be fair, because it will be dark. But yes, so all night long, we will be out here in the open air.
So are you prepared for it? Do you think you're ready?
No, I've actually got to go and buy my sleeping bag.
Right, okay.
Blinged up, obviously. Yeah. So I'm going to get some diamantes on it. Because I've never been camping before in my life, and so my first introduction is actually in the open air and even under canvas. But it's going to be fun. It's going to be fun, yes. And it's all for a good cause.
Yes. Yeah, so could you tell me a bit more about the charity for the homeless?
Yes, it's for the Sleep Easy Sleep Out, which is organised by the Guildford YMCA, and it's to raise as much funds as we possibly can to raise the profile of young homeless and the intervention programme they have in preventing young people ending up homeless and on the streets.
Great. And so is there a website that we can donate to reach you directly?
Yes, because I've got this huge £3,000 target and I'm nowhere near it yet, okay. So I really need to get some.
Yep.
It's the BT My Donate site, and very helpfully there's a fundraiser search, so if you just put Diana Roberts into that, you get straight to my bit to donate. Okay.
Well,
please.
Yeah. Well, it's been great talking to you today and hopefully we'll pop down on the night and get to see you in action.
Yes, that should be fun.
Okay, please donate on My Donate to Diana Roberts.
I'm delighted now to be catching up with Philip Green, because Philip, you're doing the marathon, aren't you, soon?
Yes, I'm doing it on the 13th of April. It's the London Marathon, so it's actually quite scary, and it's for the Children's Trust.
So you're raising lots of money?
Yes, I've raised quite a bit online and offline, but if you would like to donate, you can go to www.justgiving.com/Philip Green Run and donate as much as you can, because any money that goes towards the Children's Trust really helps.
Great. And you're doing a 10-mile one as well?
Yes, on Sunday I'm doing the 10-mile run with the Children's Trust for a good training session altogether. So yes, very scary.
It's exciting though. And tell us quickly, I know you've got your YouTube channel and you did some filming in Surrey recently with the flood. Tell us a little bit about what you've done.
I had a look at the floods in Walton area, and I tell you what, it was disastrous. I can't believe how much flooding there was. I mean, in the summer, I filmed a video called The Granny Wrap, which was a granny wrapping in a park, which was quite random.
I'm gonna have to watch that.
Yeah, go watch it. And I went back there, and where we were filming actually was at least a metre high in water. So yes, go and have a look at that on YouTube.
Great, thank you so much for coming again.
That's all right, my pleasure. Thank you, Vicky.
Shakespeare Company had their 2014 launch party last week. I went along to chat to Matt and Sarah about their ambitious year ahead.
I'm very excited to be here now at Guildford's Shakespeare Company's 2014 launch party, and I'm joined now by Matt and Sarah from the company, and I understand you've got an action-packed year happening, but Othello is your next production. Tell us a bit about it.
Yes, it is. Othello is taking place from the 5th to the 22nd of February at the beautiful Holy Trinity Church on Guildford High Street. We're setting it in Traverse Theatre, so action happening in the middle of the audiences, set in the 1950s against a backdrop of Cold War paranoia, and we've got a super cast.
Yeah, we have. They're great. They boast credits from the RSC, from the Globe, from the National, from the West End, and the creative team, the guys behind the shows, so the directors, designers, choreographers, fight directors, they've all worked with us before. They, in fact, a lot of them produced the show Macbeth that we did last year in February 2013, which 4,500 people see it, so we really hope that Macbeth, Othello, will be the same.
I'm sure it will, and I'm really hoping to come along and check it out. It sounds like fantastic. a brilliant, fantastic production.
Thank you.
Following on from a story we featured in November, we thought you would like a reminder of a unique exhibition taking place at the Lightbox Gallery in Woking next month. The gallery will be hosting the largest collection of Renoir paintings ever seen outside London, and will take you on a journey through nearly 50 years of the French Impressionists' work. The exhibition launches on the 8th of February and will run until the 20th of April. The exhibition is free, however, donation to the gallery will be warmly received. Top Gear's hamster, Richard Hammond, has backed a set of recent publications from the Children's Trust in Tadworth. The TV presenter suffered a serious brain injury himself after a high-speed car accident in 2006. The series of books have been created by the Children's Trust following the successful development of a website resource for parents of children with acquired brain injury. The website can be found at thebraininjuryhub.co.uk, and when visiting the website, look under Latest News for more information about the new books from the Children's Trust. The Guildford Flames had an interesting weekend last week. They played the Peterborough Phantoms on both Saturday and Sunday. They lost their first game 6-3, but won the return game the following day 3-2. Paul Dixon, head coach and player, said, "We are aware of the things we need to work on, and hopefully we can get some of them ironed out for the next game." The Flames are now leading the league by 1 point from the Manchester Phoenix. Their next home game at the Spectrum is on January the 26th against the Telford Tigers, and it's another Kids Go Free game. Don't forget to enter the raffle for the Little Lion portrait. The draw closes on Monday the 20th. It's been a truly eye-opening experience today at the gallery, and all the work that the foundation does is really world-changing. And to think Shalford, a tiny little village in Surrey, is right at the heart of it. Thanks for watching Surrey TV. Take care and enjoy the county. Of February and will be screened live at 8 p.m. on ITV.
Hello!
Hello, how are you?
Surprise!